Start.
Prayer brings victory. Let's all rise for the prayer. Om Guru Brahma, Guru Vishnu, Guru Devo Maheshwaraha, Guru Sakshat Parabrahma, Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha. Om Asatoma Satyamaya Tamasoma Yudhigamaya. Shanti 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 Saraswati.
Saraswati Namastubhyam Varade Kamadubhani Vidyarambham Karishyami Siddhet Bhava Tume Saga.
Atha Dvadashodhyayaha Bhakti Yogaha Arjuna Uvacha Evam Satata Yuktaye Bhaktastvam Paripasate Echapyaksharam Avyaktam Tesham Kiyoga Vittamaha Shri Bhagavan Uvacha Maya Veshyamana Emam Nitya Yukta Upasate Shraddhaya Parayopetaha Teme Yukta Tamamataha Etvaksharamanardheshyam Avyaktam Paryupasate Sarvatra Kamachintyancha Kutastamachalam Dhruvam Sanniyam Yendriya Gram Raha Te Prapnuvanti Mameva Sarvabhuta Hiterataha Kleshodhikatarastesham Avyakta Sakta Chetasam Avyakta Hikadar Dukham Dehavad Bhiravapyate. Hope we receive the blessings of the Almighty.
Now our friends are waiting to welcome us with the greeting song. Ready? 1, 2, 3, start!
Thank you for the dazzling performance, my friends. Here
Kamsa Shravan Raka Paranya to do the honors for the gathering.
A best way to get things done is to simply begin with a smile. A smile is a universal welcome. We, the strong believers of these words, start everything with a happy note. We always make our day special, greeting happy mornings to each other. Now, I would spread the same happiness here, wishing you all a very happy evening.
On behalf of Lil Champions, it's my immense pleasure to welcome each one of you to our curriculum Come Alive with our warm smiles. First, we would like to take up this opportunity to welcome and thank our Shweta auntie, who is keen in providing the same experiences and opportunities even during these pandemic days. Thank you, Shweta auntie, and welcome to our conference. We would welcome our cheerleaders, our parents who takes all effort, spend time energetically and enthusiastically to keep us engaged. Without your encouragement, we are not here. Thank you, parents. We welcome our principal Purnima auntie and our RACS teachers. And last but not the least, the ultimate twinklers of today's show. My friends, always under the same stars, finally under the same roof, who stood together to make it happen. It's our show. Welcome you all. Lastly, I would welcome and thank our lovely, cheerful Razina auntie for tolerating our mischiefs happily. Thank you.
These little rocksters have made many special moments in our learning journey of these two terms. Today we are here as evidence to proudly present our learning. We explore wonder and experiment. We grow and play. We shine, share, dream and make friends. We enjoy it. We pretend, have fun and try new things. Yes, you are right. Well, we learn many things that can't be measured. It can only be treasured. We welcome all of you to share our treasure. Sit back and enjoy.
Thank you, Shravan, Raga and Pradhanya. We are proud to share your treasures. It's always our pleasure. I think all of you agree. It's indeed a heartwarming welcome to all of us. I would take a few moments to share a thought about the day. I know all of you have a question. Why this event? Believe RACS is a purpose-built school. Anything and everything happens here serves a purpose. RACS, as a community, believes in the holistic development of every individual learner. We strongly believe that every child is unique and possesses their own strength, and we work towards building it. This event is a strong proof evident for our mission and vision accomplishment. Today, every learner of Little Champions will be able to communicate their understanding. To reach this goal, we ensure every lesson plan includes 21st century skills, which enable our learners to be effective collaborators, communicators, and creators. When they are able to explain their learning on their own, that shows the opportunity provided for metacognition to happen during the process of learning. This enables them to be independent skill achievers, and this is our ultimate success. We raise by lifting others. Here, I would like to give credits to all our lovable children who elevate our thinking to theirs during the learning process. Though there are many, I would like to share one. It may sound funny, but as the teacher, I would say, I feel proud. Sometimes we do proudly excuse ourselves for not knowing the answers for the unexpected questions posted by them. So we are actually pushed to a zone of research and get back to them with the answers. We enjoy working every moment with our Rocksters as we are learning through the journey. Their love, curiosity, bonding with us make us to go an extra mile for them every day. Thank you, children.
Hurry, Mummy, hurry up. Please help me to turn on the laptop quickly. My friends are ready for the English presentation. English is my favorite, Mummy. We are keen listeners, awesome narrators and speakers during show and tell and role play. We are also independent readers and story writers during our English session. Wow, we have so much fun with English. I have joined in at the right time. Thank God, Veda is just going to start.
What journal book are you reading, Anvita?
It's the Jungle Book, Veda.
Hey, not the title, Anvi, it's the journal. Okay, wait, here is Nikit and Anaya to explain in detail.
Hi, Anaya. I'm so ecstatic today.
What is special, Nikit?
My mommy bought me this. This is my favorite book.
Hey, Nikit, my mommy also got me this. Hooray!
Hooray! Anaya, let's have a deal. I will read it for you and you read it for me, okay?
Okay.
The Girl and the Spider. Once there lived a beautiful girl named Amila. One day, Amila was climbing the stairs to the attic to play with her toys. Alas! Her frock made out of muslin cloth was torn by a sharp nail. When Amila saw the torn hem of her favorite frock, she became very sad. She kept crying for a long time. Hearing her sobs, a spider who was busy weaving his web came out. He asked, "What made this beautiful girl sad?" Amila looked at him and sobbed. She said, "My lovely frock is torn. I'm very sad." The spider smiled and said, "Look at me. I work so hard in weaving my web. It takes hours to create my home and only a second for it to be destroyed. I had made my home only yesterday. It was ashed by a maid this morning. And I was also very sad. Then I thought, instead of being sad, I should start weaving my home again. So don't cry now. Mend your frock instead. That way, your precious tears won't be waste. Do not waste time in thinking of what is lost."
Wow, Nikki, you read so beautifully. It's my turn. Okay. All about spiders. Spiders have 8 eyes. Spiders move their legs in and out. Spiders have 8 legs. Spiders can build a web in 1 hour. There are about 40,000 different types of spiders. Spiders lay eggs and store them in an egg sack. Nikki, do you realize one thing? Both the books are of the same character. Can we share our learning to our youngsters with the help of the Venn diagram? Let's show the similarities and difference of nonfiction and fiction books.
My book is a fiction book because
my book is a nonfiction book because
my book has a title.
My book has an index.
My book has silly pictures.
My book has only diagrams.
My book has problems and solutions.
My book can be read in any order.
My book has beginning, middle, and end.
Mine is all information.
And my book has, and so my book is not real.
My book speaks only about real things. Nikki, do you think both have any similarities?
Yes, both has a title.
Both are fun to read. Learn.
Both are fun to read.
Now it's question time.
Poonima Aunty, can you tell what book is this?
Nikit, is that Fun About Animals? Find Out About Animals?
Fiction or non-fiction?
I think it's about fiction. It's a fiction.
Oh no, we are sorry. It's a non-fiction book. Because it has real pictures.
Thank you, Nikit.
Let's shower Poornima Aunty with stars.
Shower you with stars. Shower you with stars. Shower you with lot of stars. Thank you, everyone, for your participation.
Oh, Shravan, I'm finding very difficult to read this book.
Don't worry, Pranya. Here comes a large and Amuta to help us.
Rajiv, can we play a comprehension game?
Comprehension game? What is it, Amu?
You read a passage to me and check my understanding on the passage. Can you read your favorite passage to me, Rajiv?
Yes, Amu, just wait. My online assessment. My name is Amelia.
Hey, Rajiv, hold on. How will I understand if you're so quick? Remember how we solved comprehension in class?
Oh ho, sorry Amita. My online assessment. My name is Amelia. Today is my English online assessment. This is my first online assessment. I am feeling very nervous about it. My mother had taught me for my assessment. Now can you ask a question?
Yes, please, Rajiv.
What assessment did Amelia write?
Amelia wrote her English online assessment.
Well done, Amu.
Hey, I scored one. Can I take my turn to read the passage?
Yes, Amu, go ahead.
Hibernation. Animals need food to keep warm and yet energy. in the winter months. Food is scarce and it's very cold. Because of this, some animals sleep or rest all through the winter. This is called hibernation. Can I ask you a question now?
Yes, Amyu.
When do animals hibernate?
Winter. Let's give a heighten.
Our raptors also want to know how quick we are able to comprehend. We follow three steps while comprehending. Read the passage thrice. Understand new words. Answer the questions.
Can we also show our raptors how quick we are with spelling too? Understand the new words. Split up the words. Assessment. Learn this. Hibernation. Refer the new words in dictionary. Assessment means waiting something or someone. Nervous means sensitive. Hibernation means animals that sleep during winter.
Thank you, Rajiv. Hope our raptors will be able to crack the comprehension quickly.
Amita, we learned how to make our sentences interesting. What's it?
I remember it's not an idiom. It's not new words. It starts with P. Let me call upon Shravan and Pradanya to help us.
Hi, Pradanya. Can I share something about my friends?
Yes.
Peter and Glenn are my best friends. Peter and Glenn likes to play with me. Peter and Glenn enjoys playing football with me. Peter and Glenn sits beside me. Peter and Glenn plays blocks with me.
Oh, Shravan, it's... Stop it, Shravan. It's boring to listen to their names again and again. Do you remember we have learned something about this, right?
You mean pronouns?
Yes. Pronouns will take us to the place to naming words. To avoid repeating them.
Now can I make my story a little bit interesting? Peter and Glenn were my best friends. They would play with me. We enjoy playing football. They sit beside me. We play blocks.
Hey, wow, that sounds good. Do you know something, Shravan? There are also singular and plural pronouns also. Look at here. He, she, you, and I are singular pronouns. We, them, they are plural pronouns.
That's great, Shravan and Pranaya. Here is our Anvita and Veda to share all-time favorites.
Wow, I know. It's our story time. And friends, it's their story of their own. Sit back and enjoy.
Hi, friends. The title of the story is Anvita and Veda's Adventurous Day Out. Me and Veda were ecstatic to meet each other after the vacation. Hi, Veda. Hi. We were fascinated to look at the new school library. We started to explore the books and Veda found an exotic book with an amazing cover page. She wanted to crack the book with me. She asked me if we can hit the book about a memorable field trip together. I said yes.
As we were enjoying, there was an announcement. Children, pack your bags. Let's set for a field trip. We were on cloud nine and rushed down the wire to board the bus. We were enjoying the song, la 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 la, and pondering, ting, 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 where we were going. Shortly, we reached our destination. It was our favorite botanical garden, where we loved to investigate plants and their habitats. Me and Veda found an exotic flower, and out of curiosity, we wandered away. Do you all know what happened? Boom!
We lost our way from the group. After a while, we realized that we were in hot water. Keeping our fingers crossed, we started looking for our group. Out of the blue, it started raining cats and dogs. And we were running against the clock. We found a big grubby tree and decided to climb. Initially, I was skeptical about climbing the tree. I wondered if there might be any animals dwelling up there. However, Anvita assured me and both of us climbed the tree. We started looking for our group. After a keen search, we found our group. Hooray, hooray, we found them, we found them. We joined back our group and the teachers were very happy to see us back safe. The teachers gave us a pat on the back for staying cool as a cucumber and finding our way. By the time we reached home, we were ready to call it the day and we hit the hay and slept like babies. The moral of the story is never give up and always follow the instructions.
Wow, Veda and Anvi, you really deserve a big hand. We were able to show only the glimpse of few topics. We learned. Hope you all enjoyed it. Here are little champions to present few topics. Math topics. Concepts. I love math. Math hands-on is really fun. Watch out, my friends. Enjoying a few concepts of hands-on. Over to Ananya.
1, 2, 3, 4.
What that you're doing so happily, Ananya?
I'm counting.
It's fun for you too, as counting is such a fun Lakshmi and Vinayak too.
A number is
21, 20, counting is always fun.
We are
Do you know something that Little and Sanju have some number track machine which can make people young or old?
What? Is it a time machine?
No, Aro, it's a number machine. Come on, let's go ask Little and Sanju how to use it.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Hey, Little, what are you doing?
It's my birthday tomorrow, Sanju, so I am counting how many chocolates to buy.
That's lovely.
I'm going to buy 27 chocolates.
That's lovely, Little. But why do you have to get only 27? What if there are a few more people coming? So round it off to the nearest dense, Little.
That's a good idea, Sanju. Then I'll tell Mummy to get 30 chocolates.
Wow, Rithul, all our raptors are wondering what is that we are doing. Can we help them with it?
It's my pleasure, Sanju. Can you tell them the number in tens?
20, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90, 100.
Super, Sanju, a piece of cake for us. My number is 27. It comes between 20 and 30. The middle number is 25. If my number is a middle number or more than a middle number, I'll round it off to the next tens. If my number is less than the middle number, I'll round it off to the previous tens.
Thank you, Rithul. I'm sure that all our raptors would have enjoyed it. It was really fun making our family members young and old. We enjoyed it.
Rasna aunty, how old are you?
Rithul, don't let the cat out of the bag. I'm 31.
Then Rajinanti, don't let the cat out of the bag. You can tell others that you are close to 30. So we made you young.
We wish everyone to have fun with this game. Bye-bye, everyone. 19 minus 10 is what? So, 19 on my mind. 10 on my fingers. Before 19, 18, 17, 16.
What are you doing? Please wait. Kushi and Ananya are here to make it easy for us.
Hi, Kushi.
Why are you feeling sad, Ananya?
Because I'm finding difficult to find 10 less than any number, but I know how to find 1 less than any number.
Oh, are you sad because of that? Hey, come on, Ananya, cheer up. I will help you. First, you explain me how will you find 1 less than any number.
If my number is 45, I will keep my cutoff on 45. And I will flip 1 less, so I got 1 less than 45, is 44, easy.
Great, Ananya. Now, can you tell me if your question is 45 and you got the answer 44, which place you can see the change of the number?
One place I could see the change.
Okay, so now tell me, if your number is 1, the change is in the 1's place. What if it is with 10? I will tell you.
Now my number is again the same number 45. And if I do 10 less than my number is 35. So where can you see the change in the 10th place? So I can see the change in the 10th place.
Thank you, Kushi, for your help. Now I can crack it easily.
Lakshmi, you are the smallest happy numbers.
What do you say, happy numbers?
Okay, Riya and Aruna will be the right person to tell us.
I have slipped out of your mind. What is that you are thinking, having all the number cards in front of you?
Just thinking, what game can I play with these number cards?
Hold your horses, Aram. I also have number cards.
Can we play our lottery well? We will have a race. I choose to be odd, so I'll only find odd numbers.
Okay, then I will choose to be an even, so I'll only find even numbers. Come on.
Anyama.
Get set.
Get set. Go. That's the number cards. Ma'am, one is your odd number.
Two is an even.
Ma'am, three is your odd number.
Four is an even number.
Ma'am, five is your odd number.
Six is an even number.
Ma'am, 7 is your odd number.
8 is an even number.
9 is odd or even?
Arav, I think 9. Let me check if they are having partners. 1 is not having a partner. Then I think it's an odd number, Arav. Am I right?
Rasina aunty, is a 10 odd or even?
Riya, when we lift 10 fingers, can we try to pair it? 1. Okay, this also have partners. This also have partners. Everyone are having partners. So all of them are happy. So it's an even number.
You are right, auntie.
Thank you, Riya.
Bingo!
Bingo! I know you are all thinking, why we have worn our happy and sad face crown.
This is how
we had fun when we learned odd and even.
I am wearing a happy face crown because all the even numbers have friends when we pair them. For example, if I take number 4, first 2 also have friends, next 2 also have friends. So, all even numbers are happy.
I am wearing a sad face crown because all my odd numbers does not have friends when we pair them. One of them is always left alone. For example, if we take 3, I can only make 1 pair and my other friend is left alone, so they are sad.
Cannot be so easy. Thank you, friends, for the demonstration. Are you all taking a deep breath feeling, wow, we little scientists are provided with an opportunity to be explorers, observers, investigators. How can we not present that to you?
Taruni, what are you wondering about?
Raga, I was just watching Rohan sometime. He's fidgeting with something. I don't know what he's up to.
I think Visha is going to ask him about that. Come, let's also join Rohit and Visha.
Hey, Rohit, what are you playing?
Hi, Visha. I found this magnet as I was exploring my toy box while playing.
How do you do that? Wow, show me.
I am checking which of my toys are magnetic. Want to see?
How do you do that and why do you do that?
Like this, Visha.
By the way, what is magnetic, Rohit?
You see, Visha, if an object can attract to a magnet, it's called magnetic. Now let me try this. I bring the magnet close to the scissor and see if it attracts. Yay, it does!
How it is happening and why it is happening?
For example, my toy car is made of metal. My nail is made of iron. Only these materials attract to a magnet are called magnetic materials.
That's interesting. So you mean that the object that ripples with the magnet is non-magnetic?
That's right, Visha. Look for some more non-magnetic materials.
Rohit, I found few here. This is my pencil made of wood. And this is my box made of plastic. These does not attract to the magnet. So these are non-magnetic materials. Isn't it, Rohit?
Right, Visha, you are right.
Super, Rohit. It was so much fun. Let us quickly sort the items with magnetic and non-magnetic materials. Hooray, we did it!
Did it! Ooh, ooh.
Rohan, I'm already scared of that skeleton.
Oh, Nila, that is just Taruni.
Isn't it? Let me call and see. Taruni, Taruni.
Hi, everyone. My little children, please don't get scared of me. I am not going to harm you. Do you remember who I am? I was brought to all your classes by an auntie when you were introduced to the skeletal system. And also Dr. Minox spoke about me. Yes. You are right. I am a skeleton. I am a little champion. Can you guess me? It is me, the skeleton of Taruni.
Boo!
Ha ha ha. I am the framework and the guard of all her internal organs. Hey, Raxtus, I am glad to introduce my friends. My friend bone is protection, brain is called the skull. Another bone is protection, heart is called the rib cage. We are all friends together, so we can stay connected with each other. Do you know a secret? I am made up of more than 200 bones. But when you were a baby, I was 300 in number. It is silly, then now I am less, and then I was more. You all are endoskeletons, as I am inside your body. If I am outside your body, you would be called an exoskeleton. It is the longest and strongest bone in your femur, in your thighs. The shortest bone is the stapes in the middle ear. Do you also know that half of your bones are in your hands and feet? Quite surprising, right? I help you in all your movements. I take pride to say that I am keeping you busy. My dear little Rakshas, I am very important to keep you happy and energetic with sports and games. So kindly take care of me by eating your fruits and vegetables and drinking your milk. Bye, I'm going inside Taruni. She's waiting for me to help her. Bye, see you.
Vishal looked at all the scary faces. Ha ha ha. Aitak's heroine is munching on a healthy sandwich.
Mommy, I'm hungry now. But how can you say that he's eating healthy sandwich?
I could see him always eating fruit and vegetables.
Fruit and sandwich? No way.
Come, let us go find out Sunila and Rohan.
Hi, Rohan. Had your snack?
Yes, Nila. I had a vegetable sandwich, juicy tomatoes, corn and crunchy lettuce. Yum.
Do you know the tomato is a fruit?
What? No, it is a vegetable.
When it has seeds, it is a fruit.
So are the vegetables like lady's finger and bitter gourd are also fruits?
Yes, all vegetables that have seeds are scientifically called fruits.
That is interesting. What are vegetables then?
We eat root, stem, flower. They are the vegetables.
Yep, you mean we eat the roots of the plant?
Do you like carrot?
That's my favorite.
Fruit is favorite. Ha ha ha. Look here, Rohan.
Leaf makes food with rain, sun, and air. This food is used for the growth of the plant. Now there are some extra food stored. This is stored in the different parts of plant like fruit, root, flower, seed, stem, and leaf. That is how fruits and vegetables are found.
Wow, that is amazing, Rohan.
Science always gave us great surprises.
Yes, let us eat all the edible parts of the plant and stay healthy.
We agree with you, Nela. We should all eat healthy and live healthy. Where do we live? The place we dwell is called our habitat. Now, here is our researcher, Raga, to present her finding about the rainforest and the polar habitat.
Hey everyone, I have made a model of a rainforest. I have made this model by reusing the old materials, using brown paper cover for the barks of the tree and fabric for the grasses and trees. Do you all know what is a rainforest? These are wet and warm habitats. These rainforests receive heavy rainfalls throughout the year. There are different kinds of plants and animals living here. These forests provide 20% of oxygen that all of us need in the world to breathe. Anaya, do you know which is the largest rainforest in the world?
Amazon rainforest.
You are right, Anaya. Amazon in South America is the largest rainforest in the world. These rainforests are divided in four layers, that is, emergent, understory, shrubs, and the ground. And now I like to present my polar habitat. Polar habitats cover. I have made this polar habitat using sponges and thermocoles. Do you all know how I made my little penguins? My penguins are made of pistachios. Now let's see the habitat. Polar habitat covers the top and bottom of planet Earth. It is fully surrounded by ice. The North Pole is surrounded by Arctic Ocean, and the South Pole is located in Antarctica. It has two seasons, that is summer season and winter season. It's too much cold and dry for any trees to grow. Polar bears, Arctic fox, walrus, and whales live here. Many kinds of penguins are also found here. Hope the information given will help you. Thank you.
We also would like to present few memorable moments of our favorite wild friends. There we go. Wild, watch the slides. We know you all want more, but our time is up. We must find time to stop and thank people who make a difference. Here is the time for us to stop for today and to thank each one of you. The valuable time you all had been able to spend and the patience you had for us is amazing. Thank you, one and all.
As the beautiful quote says, your little faith in me makes me feel special and loved every day. Yes, today we all felt very special and loved as we, the students of Little Champion, were trusted by the school, teachers, parents, who have been a great support to us to lead the conference. The students led conference. Thank you again. This has taught us not only to present our learning,
We were also given a chance to communicate, collaborate, create our own, make materials with the available resources.
I'd like to call upon Razina. Ms. Razina, who has been getting these 21 little champions together and working with them back home, though this year has been quite hectic with the virtual classes and unable to have these children with us physically. Hats off to you, Razina, and the little champions. Great job by you all.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Rex, for creating such an impression in our learning journey. Finally, yes, we all of us together have one voice. Thank you, everyone. And we miss our Rex campus. Shwetanti, thank you for giving us this opportunity. But we have one request to you. Can we ask?
I know what the request is, but go ahead, Nikit.
Give me some sunshine. Give me some rain. Give me another chance to come to school again. La 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 la. Give me some sunshine. Give me some rain. Give me another chance to come to school again.
Very soon, Veda. We'll have you all over very soon. Yes. And I'd like to also thank all the parents who have been behind.
Excuse me, ma'am. They have something for you.
And I would just like to make a mention, and we really appreciate the efforts put in by all the parents who have been collaborators with the teachers and the school to make this a possibility with the children over. Thank you, parents.
Welcome, ma'am.
Yes, parents can start. Arif?
Give me some sunshine.
Give me some rain.
Give me another chance to come to school again.
La 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 la
la la la la la la la la
la la la la la la.
Give me some sunshine.
Give me some rain.
Give me another chance.
Where will you
school again?
School again. Wait, I'm going
to
wait. La la
la la.
La la la.
Give me some sunshine.
Give me some rain.
Give me another chance
to come to school again.
Come to school again.
La 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 la. La 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 la. La 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 la. La 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 la.
La 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 la.
La 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 la.
La 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 la.
Give me some sunshine.
Give me some rain.
Parents, would you want to pitch in and do you have anything to say with your experiences?
It's actually a great effort. So this is Pradnya's mom, Priya.
We had a lot of practices, and I think I should especially, not just me, myself, but most of the parents would agree with me. We greatly appreciate Razina ma'am's, efforts, the amount of time and patience, the effort she had put in is simply amazing. I don't know where she gets that energy from. So thank you, Razina ma'am, once again.
Thank you so much for organizing
such a great event. It has been a fantastic journey for the past couple of weeks. And that's it from me.
Thank you, Auntie, for all the efforts.
Thank you, Auntie.
Thank you, Auntie.
Thank you, Auntie.
Thank you so much, children. Love you all. And you all did it. Very good.
Thank you so much.